Hello, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to make a video to show you how to make some small custom content recolors. Okay, how to make a recolor of a Sims 4 item. First you need to go and find what you want to make a recolor of and what you're allowed to make a recolor of. Just go to hoodies, then you just have to check each one until you find one that you can use. See this one? This one says yes, awesome. Changing the color or whatever. Okay, that's downloaded. Then you just going to want to take it and put it in your Sims 4 studio. What I want to do is get rid of this writing on here. So I am going to just a little bit of gray color and then like paint over it. Then I'm going to smudge it. Basically going to have to do that with the whole thing. Just the grey area. Okay, I think that's going to create some interesting effects on this hoodie. I downloaded already. Let me just find them. Let's just take this one. I have like a few images, okay. So I'm just going to resize it, put it in the middle. I'm going to use a fuzzy tool. just remove the white background. Just try and get as much of the background as possible. Okay, we're going to delete that layer. Just want to make sure it is the right size. Okay. There we go, then we're going to export this. I'm just going to overwrite the previous one. Going to go back to SimSchool Studio, and then I first add a swatch, then I would say import. Okay, well, the smudging actually worked out quite good. I like it. Let me try another one. Let's try this. Import. I imported the wrong one, that one. Okay, so now I can see that there's like this line here. So I just go back to GIMP, use the eraser, make sure you select that image. Leave the opacity like that, you can sort of see the detail. Just say enter. Okay. Then I am going to use this tool with this item on top. Make sure you select the gradient. Let's just go to the end. You're going to outline the part you want the gradient to cover. Okay, then you delete the layer where the gradient was on, then you move the texture down to the bottom, then you'll see it. It looks, everything looks good. Then you're going to export it, just name it 3. And then in SimSchool Studio, add a swatch, import that one, and then there we go. Then you're just going to, okay, I'm going to remove that one, just give it colors, let's make that, just add a pink, save it. Just put it in your mods. Don't forget to add the original mesh in your mods as well, otherwise it will not work. If you did not add the original mesh, then it is going to look like this. This is how it looks if you did not add the original mesh. And this is what it looks like, and it actually came out pretty good. If you would like a tutorial video on how to make your own custom thumbnail. I'm not quite sure why it's showing like this now. I think it's because we put the original mesh first. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you learned from this video how to create the recolors. If you're not subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe and stay tuned for more content.